Come on, God. Answer me. With years, I'm asking you why. Why are the innocent dead and the guilty alive? Where is justice? Where is punishment? Or have you already answered? Have you already said to the world, here is justice, here is punishment, here?
Four young lads in Valleys of Wales watching pornographic videos on the telly. And
the camera.
So, let's mix a bit of that pornographic magazines and videos with some rock and roll. And that's what we did, basically. We rocked and roll with a lot of pervy thoughts and that.
and came up with To Make It Our Go.
For sure.
That's how we did it.
Thank you. This is dedicated to anyone who's gonna... anything to anyone who's got a house in Trill.
Yeah. So what's your point of view of the events in Nuremberg? You know,
well,
and this trouble.
What's your point of view of the events in Nuremberg?
Well,
shouldn't have happened, really. Should it?
It's all a lot of violence, really, wasn't it? Over nothing. A load of silliness, you know. Basically, everybody could have a good time and it ended up with violence, you know.
Basically,
but that's the way it goes.
And that is it. It shouldn't have happened. Like, I don't see why people want to fight when they can just get drunk, have a good time and listen to music, you know.
You know that the guy who beat you up was one of the security members, you know.
He didn't actually get beaten up.
I think the story behind that is the fact that he had too much alcohol in his system and he didn't really know what he was doing, basically.
He didn't know what was happening. I don't think he understood.
I think a certain amount was a language barrier as well.
Yeah, that was the problem when you shouted at the microphone more. I think do you want us to fucking play, you said, and I think he understood it wrong, and then
there was definite language problem in that case.
I think
but basically it shouldn't have happened.
What's the difference between concerts that you make in England and in Germany?
No one's bothered anymore, so everybody's pretty dead in Britain.
Yeah, I've heard in Britain the people are a lot more tolerant, you know?
Tolerant? Well, you can't have a lot more tolerance than 20 people at a gig. It's not a lot of people who go to gigs.
Live music.
Anymore.
In Britain, live music is gone down the toilet. Everyone wants to listen to records in Britain now. It's not just psychobilly. It's not just rock and roll. It's like everything, every form of live music.
Even blues.
Even Motorhead or like top bands are feeling it.
No one has any money in England.
The promoters are shit as well. That's another thing. The promoters
in England.
In England, yeah, fuck off bands. They're sort of like the promoters aren't half as good as the promoters in Germany. They don't know what they're doing. They don't know how to treat people.
Yeah. The gigs are far better in Germany. The organisation is far better in Germany, as I've seen it so far. I mean,
people get into it more, basically.
People let go of themselves more in Germany. In England, people want to sit by the bar, very pretty, you know, ooh, I don't want to mess my hair up, you know, ooh, dear. Whereas Germany, they tend to let go a lot more.
Thank you. South Park River White in a world of scattered by a woman, prevalent in a word.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So what's with the rumor that some members, some ex-members of Demented and some members from Screwdriver joined a new band named Clarence?
Well, it was ex-members who went with the new band, basically. Nothing to do with us.
It's like,
if you're in Demented Argo, you're in Demented Argo, and you leave Demented Argo, you do other things, you know? Yeah. It's nothing to do with us what they do when they're not with us.
There are some catalogues in Germany which indicates Demented Argo and Screwdriver are Clansmen.
Well, I'd like to make a point of it now that it's an absolute load of
bloody rubbish,
as we say in England.
There's no way that Demented Argo can be a right-wing... There is no way that Demented Argo could be a right wing, like have a right wing viewpoint, because we have a Jewish fiddle player who is called Simon Cohen, and like we're not into politics whatsoever. We don't sing about political things.
Yeah.
We hate all politics. Politics is bollocks.
Yeah, bollocks.
And all politics. The fiddle player designed the fuck politics t-shirts, all the fuck politics stuff. So, I mean, that speaks for itself, really.
At first. But then we saw them.
What did you see?
We saw creatures. We saw creatures. These. Things that are swimming around in the air and fill it all the time.
Are they around us now?
You bet.
We'll be right back.
edge of him, of Sparky. The real edge.
Ask him.
35, 35, 26, 22.
22. It's a question
that
we'll have to ask you.
Yeah, a question. How old
are
you? Go on.
How old do you think I am? How old do you think I am?
Just giving away,
man. How old do you think I am?
I think 25.
25? Well, you're close. You're close. I'm around about that age.
How old are you?
Well, give it
a little older.
Didn't take a year either.
Yeah.
No, I'm 42 actually. 41?
19? 17? What was it last week?
This week.
Or 28.
Anyway,
yeah, you'll have to ask his mum on that one.
Yeah. His mother's the best person to ask.
Yeah.
If you can get hold of her.
Yeah.
Mothers, they know best, don't they?
When he was born, he can't really remember the year. So his mother is the best one to ask.
None of us can remember.
What do your mother think about what you're doing?
She thinks it's a nice bit of a rock and roll when you're sipping a cup of tea over the Sunday dinner, but she thinks the lyrics are a bit gross, basically. And that's about it, really.
Besides that, she loves it.
Yeah. She loves it. I don't believe this.
Yeah.
We went to your granny's 80th and she didn't mind us much.
No, she's rock and roll.
Nah, most of the mothers.
Nah.
Most of the mothers sort of get into it. Like, all our parents are into the fact that we're doing something, you know what I mean? Yeah. We're not bumming around doing nothing, you know? We're actually doing something. So I think they're pretty pleased that we're actually doing something, basically. To cut a long story short.
Yeah.
time. And ich bitte was Meyer, so. Okay, thank you for the interview.
Right.
Das war das Interview mit Demented Are Go aus London. Die Kultband der 90er Jahre, die auch, also ja, wahrscheinlich schon abgedreht, ne?
We'll have to all look at the camera.